Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're going to be bringing up a subject that we discussed last year in March of 2018, March 16th to be exact. There was a listing posted on Amazon for Modern Warfare 2 Remastered, and then it was removed. Over the next couple of months, people would talk about Modern Warfare 2 Remastered and how it was supposed to release only a short time before the release of Call of Duty Black Ops 4. However, it never came to fruition, and that's due to a bunch of other things happening behind the scenes. But it was rumored for the time that Modern Warfare 2 Remastered was only campaign, no multiplayer. It was also rumored that they decided to delay it because it would be silly not to add multiplayer, and of course, I was one of the people who firmly believed that. However, over the past couple of months, more recently, we've gotten even more information about this that includes a remaster for MW2 and MW3. We've also gathered even more information from folks like the Woo Lads, who have inside information directly from people that work at Activision. We also know that there's some sort of contractual agreement between Activision and Sony to do Modern Warfare 2 Remastered and Modern Warfare 3 Remastered, leading up to the rumored MW4 that Infinity Ward is supposedly releasing this year in 2019. So here's where things get a little bit more confusing than what I would like. First off, we have Modern Warfare 2 Remastered that's been rumored to release last year. We saw Amazon listings go up and then quickly get removed. This is probably going to release sometime within Q1 of 2019. So that's January, February, or March. Somewhere in that time period, we're most likely going to see it. If we don't, then it's probably going to be within Q2. And then what's going to happen is Modern Warfare 3, for some reason, I just feel it in my gut, it's probably going to be bundled with MW4. That way people can get caught up with the campaign if they wanted to, or they're going to do some sort of mega pack where MW1, 2, and 3 are all bundled with MW4. I feel like it would be marketing gold. They could do it. They could say, here you know, here's the entire story, where it is so far, and now you can play it all in one bundle on your PS4 or on your Xbox One or whatever the case may be. The other thing that could potentially happen is we have that weird year where Infinity Ward is probably developing the game for not only the PS4 and Xbox One, but also for the PS5 and Xbox 2 or whatever it's going to be called. We all know that it is rumored that Sony is going to announce and potentially release PS5 by the end of this year. And if that companionship still goes forward with Activision and Sony, I would highly, highly think that they're still going to release this game on the next-gen console, similar to what we saw with Call of Duty Ghosts. Of course, that created a huge split in player base, but the rumor, of course, for PS5 is everything that we have on PS4 is going to be backwards compatible, which would be absolutely excellent if that's the case. So I guess the biggest question is, for a lot of people, including myself, are we going to end up getting what is, admittedly, and I guess you would say factually, the most popular Call of Duty game remastered in a multiplayer, which is MW2? Are we going to get that again? And I think, and a lot of other people would think this too, you would be silly not to. See, with the contract, the rumor is they're only contracted to do the campaign to bridge the gap to MW4. They don't have to go and give us multiplayer. They aren't required to do that. At least I don't think they are. It really does make me wonder what the heck is going to happen with these games, because if Modern Warfare 2 Remastered came out, would you buy it for the campaign? For me, that's an easy yes, because I liked the campaign. It was one of my favorites in the entire Call of Duty series. I would like to go through and have that again and experience that again in 4K, remastered for our current gen consoles. For other people, it might be a resounding no. People didn't like the campaign. They really preferred the multiplayer. They want to go for nukes with their Harrier chopper gunner nuke setup. They want to use the AC-130 again. They want to play on maps like Subbase. These are things that people love, including myself, so I would like to see them again. But they aren't required to do that, so I don't really know what's going to happen at this point. And of course, knowing that they have to do MW2 and MW3 within this 10-month time period, you know, maybe with that extra few months they had, they could squeeze out multiplayer for MW2, but for MW3, maybe it's just going to get thrown to the wayside. Maybe it's just going to be that campaign. And even so, I would still buy it because, once again, I want the entire campaign experience. It would be cool to play it all on one disc with MW4, but I don't know if that is possible in the slightest. I guess my biggest question to all of you guys that are watching this right now, if you had the opportunity to get the entire Modern Warfare trilogy on your PS4, minus the multiplayer, would you do it? This is the same question I asked last year. There were a lot of people that said yes. Maybe your mind has changed now since we, of course, have Black Ops 4. Would Modern Warfare 4 multiplayer be enough for you? I mean, imagining what they could potentially do, that raises a lot of questions. Going back to the modern era, having realistic weaponry, having actual streaks that will decimate. I mean, these are things that could potentially rebuild the Call of Duty community from what has broken off of it. And I think it could be, potentially, the biggest Call of Duty game we have seen in years, if it's done correctly. If it's another Infinite Warfare or another Ghosts, I don't really know what's going to happen to this community. I highly doubt they would go back to Infinite Warfare. If they do, that is basically the nail in the coffin. Unless they do something where there's boots on the ground and it's more of a modern era, I can't see it. I really can't, because we know that Infinite Warfare was in the future and there were specialists in that game. If they go back to more of a customizable, you get to put on your pro perks, you get to have crazy awesome streaks, you can have your character that's set in reality, you can still customize it with outfits and things like that, I think it could be a smash hit. Ghosts 2? I think Ghosts 2 could be a smash hit. Ghosts wasn't that bad of a game looking back on it now and seeing all the stuff that we've gotten over the years. Ghosts was actually a really fun game. It got a lot of shit, it caught a lot of flack, but overall, that is a game that I can still go back and enjoy today. Anyway, guys, let me know what y'all think down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed this commentary here today, drop a like on it. Don't forget to click that subscribe button to see more videos coming each and every day. Join the notification squad by clicking the bell icon and putting on notifications. And of course, guys, don't forget to subscribe to my second channel, Prestige is Key 2. For more videos, you guys can check them out over there. I will catch you all in the next one. Peace.